barely 6 years old, beckoned into a shop. A little shack made of wood and plastic boards, tattered like my childhood. Sadzadam, Shepherd. These are the names of sweeties we used to like. They have one or two of anything you like. A creaking sound, a banging sound, darkness, a locked door. Neighbor, friend of fathers, known him all my life. Makadi and Yubaba. This is how we used to greet our elders. Baba, who are you calling Baba? Age is nothing but a number, money. A wisdom unfamiliar to us. Minutes slow to pass like tortoises. Hands into fists transform. Smiles long gone. You just call me sweetie. You just call me sweetie, and maybe I'll give you all these sweeties. But I couldn't. That would be rude. Elders are to be respected as if they are our very own parents. You little prostitute! I was confused. That is a word I'm sure I did not know. But a word I'm sure I had heard before. Father calls mother that word when a scar or two he has had. A scar is father's favorite brew. I think they call it a scar because it is the ability to turn a home into a wall. But this was Baba Tashinda, the kindest businessman in all of Makua. Come close. Closer. Closer still. Do you want a sweetie or not? I do. He shuffled closer. Hovered over. Eyes like laser piercing my little boy. Shh. If you ever dare to tell anybody, I'll tell the whole village that you're a little thief. I'll say you tried to run away with a packet of sweeties you did not pay for. Little village prostitute or respected businessman, who do you think they will believe? Huh? You do not want to be arrested by the police now, do you? I said no, but what for? I did not know. Police arrest little children who are naughty, I was told. Now, be a good girl and drop your skirt. I did. God, it hurt. Gave me a sweetie after. Said it would make everything better. It didn't. I bled and bled and bled. But the fear, the sheer fear in my bones was much redder and much stickier than the blood staining my skirt. Mommy, mama, I cried. No reply. Sprawled on the floor. Crawled to the door. Again, he shuffled closer. Over and over, and did it again and again and again. And each time he did it, I'm sure I died. And then he sighed and stretched and rubbed his big pot belly in a way that said he was deeply satisfied. The way one gets satisfied by a cold cup of my hell on a scorching hot day. Mahewu is a traditional drink that grandmother lovingly made out of leftover food. Throwing away food was not the thing to do in those days. The smiles returned, fists unclenched, and the door opened. And daylight crashed in like a storm in the middle of the night and blinded my eyes. More sweeties? No, thank you. Staggered outside, confused still, words in my ears ringing like bells in the seminary. Prostitute, thief, police, prostitute, thief, police. I tried to make it all go away. Mama smelled a rat. She asked, and I told. You should understand. But I was wrong. She cleaned me up, told me to shut up and grow up. Family or shame, she said. Our neighbor, he's a kind man, she said. Take a look and see at all this sugar and ufu he gives us for free. Ufu is the stuff out of which our food is made. The sugar and ufu did not stop coming, and all I had to do was to be good and do as mother said. This is what it means to be a woman, my dear child. This is what it means to be a woman. We all had to grow up before our time. Why do you think they call our village Makuba? Makuba is the Shona word for graves. Graves of little girls who did not shut up and grow up. I tried to grow up like mother and grandmother had, and all the women of Makuba before me. But I just did not know how not to be a child. I wondered if the graves after which our village is named would swallow me whole while I slept like a cup of Mahewu. I wondered, is this what they mean when they say we're children of the soil? The cold nights, long shadows, creaking sounds and locked doors, sprawled on the floor, wallowing in anguish. They said I was possessed, said I needed to be cleansed. Father took me to the pastor's house. Pastor is God's representative on earth, Father said. Does God rape little children who are naughty too? Now 32, still feeling scarred, scared, and dirty. Want to tell my husband? No, I should. But how can I justify refusing to grow up at my foregone age? How dare I preach the gospel of shame against the gods of the earth? The wounds are too deep. My bones are too sore. The screams are too loud. Family or shame? Family or shame? Which would you choose? Thank you.